Hi, my name is Dr. Lee-Shing Chang, and I'm an associate physician and endocrinologist at Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. In this video, we'll be discussing SGLT2 inhibitors and heart failure. The key takeaways from this video are to understand the cardiovascular outcomes trials that first indicated the benefit of SGLT2 inhibitors in heart failure, and to understand the major heart failure outcomes trials underpinning the current use of SGLT2 inhibitors in heart failure with reduced ejection fraction and in heart failure with preserved ejection fraction. The story of how SGLT2 inhibitors were found to have significant benefit in heart failure starts largely with the cardiovascular outcomes trials done for them. SGLT2 inhibitors were initially designed as medications for use in diabetes because their main mechanism of action is inducing glucosuria by inhibiting the sodium glucose cotransporter 2 pump located in the proximal nephron. SGLT2 is responsible for most of the reabsorption of filtered glucose. The FDA mandated in 2008 that all new type 2 diabetes medications had to prove cardiovascular safety. The results of this mandate were that the first major cardiovascular outcomes trials with SGLT2 inhibitors were published, the first one being EMPA-REG OUTCOME in 2015. Not only did EMPA-REG OUTCOME show cardiovascular safety, but it also showed a significant reduction in major adverse cardiovascular events. A secondary outcome in EMPA-REG OUTCOME was hospitalization for heart failure, and EMPA-REG OUTCOME also showed a significant reduction in this outcome with empagliflozin. You can see here a 35% risk reduction. This heart failure benefit was seen as a secondary outcome in subsequent trials, including CANVAS program with canagliflozin, DECLARE TIMI-58 with dapagliflozin, and VIRTUS with ertugliflozin. These findings prompted dedicated outcomes trials studying hospitalization for heart failure and adverse heart failure outcomes as a primary composite outcome. I've summarized the major heart failure outcomes trials that have been completed as of 2021 here. Dapagliflozin has been studied in heart failure with reduced ejection fraction in DAPA-HF. Empagliflozin has been studied in both heart failure with reduced ejection fraction and heart failure with preserved ejection fraction in the EMPEROR-reduced and EMPEROR-preserved studies, respectively. All three of these studies showed a significant reduction in the primary composite endpoint of worsening heart failure and cardiovascular death. Let's take a closer look at each study. In DAPA-HF, participants with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, defined as an ejection fraction less than or equal to 40%, despite optimal medical therapy, and New York Heart Association class 2 through 4 were included. They also had to have an elevated NT-proBNP and an eGFR of at least 30. Participants were randomized to receive either dapagliflozin 10 mg daily or placebo. The primary outcome was a composite of worsening heart failure, which was defined either as an unplanned hospitalization or an urgent visit resulting in intravenous therapy for heart failure, or death from cardiovascular causes. The results showed a significant 26% reduction in the primary outcome. Dapagliflozin also reduced all-cause mortality, resulted in lower heart failure symptoms, and improved physical function and quality of life. Interestingly, the benefits were seen early, and you can see that by taking a look at the early separation in the curves in the graphs from the outcomes shown here. In the EMPEROR-reduced trial, participants with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, defined as an ejection fraction of less than or equal to 40%, despite optimal medical therapy and NYHA class 2 through 4, were included. Participants also had to have an eGFR of at least 20. They were randomized to receive either empagliflozin 10 mg daily or placebo. The primary outcome was a composite of hospitalization for heart failure or cardiovascular death. This was analyzed as the time to the first event. The results showed a significant 25% reduction in the primary outcome. Empagliflozin was also associated with an improvement in quality of life. In heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, we have multiple pharmacologic therapies that improve clinical outcomes. However, in heart failure with preserved ejection fraction, or HFpEF, far less progress in treatment options has been made. In the EMPEROR PRESERVE study, participants with HFpEF defined as an ejection fraction greater than 40%, despite optimal medical therapy, and NYHA classes 2 through 4 were included. Participants also had to have an eGFR of at least 20. They were randomized to receive either empagliflozin 10 milligrams daily or placebo. The primary outcome in the EMPEROR PRESERVED was a composite of hospitalization for heart failure or cardiovascular death. This was analyzed as the time to the first event. The results showed a significant 21% reduction in the primary outcome, which was mainly driven by a 29% reduction in hospitalization for heart failure. Empagliflozin is now the first and only medication to significantly improve outcomes across the spectrum of heart failure, including heart failure reduced and preserved ejection fraction. All three of these trials were specifically designed to include a majority of participants who did not have type 2 diabetes. Just under 50% of participants in each trial had type 2 diabetes at baseline. Pre-specified subgroup analyses showed that a significant reduction in the primary outcome occurred regardless of type 2 diabetes status. Based on the results of these studies, empagliflozin and dapagliflozin now have heart failure-specific FDA indications for use in individuals, regardless of underlying type 2 diabetes, as shown here. The indication for heart failure with preserved ejection fraction is currently undergoing FDA review for an indication as of early 2022. Guidelines in heart failure and type 2 diabetes have already been updated to include these groundbreaking trials. As shown here, the American College of Cardiology, as of 2021, recommends that for patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, be considered to start dapagliflozin or empagliflozin for those with NYHA classes 2 through 4 as part of guideline-directed medical therapy. Our European counterparts with the European Society of Cardiology have also recommended dapagliflozin or empagliflozin for patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction to reduce the risk of hospitalization for heart failure and death. And the American Diabetes Association, or ADA, published their standards of care in 2022 to recommend for patients with type 2 diabetes and heart failure that dapagliflozin or empagliflozin be considered independent of baseline A1C, individualized A1C target, or metformin use. Of note, the ACC and ESC manuscripts were published in 2021 before the results of EMPEROR PRESERVED were published. So the ACC and ESC statements do not yet mention empagliflozin for use in HFpEF or heart failure with preserved ejection fraction. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this topic helpful.